Hi, I'm doing a video review of the Virgin Mobile smartphones of the Blackberry 8530 and the Samsung Intercept. I know I already did these in a different review, but there were some questions, so I thought I would re-review them and focus on just these two phones. With the Blackberry 8530, it does have a small keyboard. It took a little adjusting to get used to, but what I do like about this one is the raised keys. They feel really nice. Easy to find your way. You have a hold down lock over here. You have your speakerphone. To unlock the buttons, you hold down the mute button. This is mute, play, fast forward, rewind. Up here you have your speaker. Over here on the side you have your volume up, volume down. You don't hold them in. You go press, press, press. They are kind of hard, which is nice. If you throw it in your pocket, you're not accidentally turning it up and down. This one right now is a programmable button, and it's programmed for the camera, but you can change it to whatever you want. So this button and this button is programmable. You have your USB, your headphone jack. This one is currently programmed for voice commands, which is a very nice feature.
Say a command.
Contacts.
Say the number.
555-1212.
Did you say call 555-1212?
Yes.
Calling.
And that's it. With the Samsung Intercept, it does have a touch screen with an on-screen keyboard. As well as a slide-out QWERTY board. Big, nice arrow keys. I really like the arrow keys. The one thing I don't care for on this one is the keys on it are flat and they feel spongy. So you have your mic, that is your camera button, your headphone jack, USB, volume up, volume down, and the micro SD slot. Both the BlackBerry 8530 and the Samsung Intercept have about the same battery life, and it depends on what applications that you're running. Applications with the Intercept, also what widgets you're running. But the BlackBerry has an added feature to help save battery life, such as schedule daily automatic turn phone off and turn phone on times. You can turn the cell connection off individually from the Wi-Fi connection. So if you're just using the Wi-Fi and you don't really want the cell phone connection on, you can turn them off individually, one or the other. So that's a nice feature for helping with the battery. Also, when your battery starts to go really low on this, it will shut the radio connections off of the cell and the Wi-Fi, which should give you just a little extra time to be able to access your files before it completely dies. With the Samsung Intercept, you have the option to turn the Wi-Fi on or off, Bluetooth, but you do not have the option to shut the cell phone connection off, although you can put it in airplane mode. But with the Samsung Intercept, to also save a little bit of battery life, you can shut down sharing background data, and that will help too. For a camera, the 8530 has a 2 megapixel camera. The pictures are okay on the 8530, but they seem slightly saturated. With the Intercept, it has a 3.2 megapixel camera. Of these two phones, the Intercept has the better photo quality, truer colors of the two phones. It even has a scene mode, a macro mode, more color effects, metering. And a tip on the Intercept, you can take faster pictures in between if you take the focus off of auto mode and set it to infinity. Okay, let's go ahead and look at the music on here. Let you listen to, this is Queen, I Want to Break Free. It's pretty good for Virgin Mobile breaking free from the contracts. And then let's go over here to the Samsung Intercept. With customization, the 8530 has simple customization of add folder, move applications to folder, and hide. But the 8530 lacks eye candy, although it doesn't have any navigation lag. It just goes right to what you're doing. So in here you can see your options for customizing. You can also, when you make a folder, you can move it onto your home screen and make a folder of your favorite applications so that you can have more up here. With the Samsung Intercept, the Intercept customization is easy. It's with the touch screen. It's drag and drop. So here you can drag stuff onto the home screen, drag it around on the home screen, and then you can drag it into the trash off the home screen. With for PC connection and compatibility, with the Samsung Intercept, there are no 64-bit downloadable drivers from Samsung. And sometimes some people have found that the USB data cable on the Intercept has, it's been reported as having issues. That it, and if they replace it with a generic USB cable, that will fix it. I have issues with Windows 7 64-bit where it doesn't always work, and sometimes restarting the computer and restarting the phone, I can get it to connect to transfer the files off the card one time. Save yourself a headache and just get a card reader. But with the 8530, it just works even without the desktop syncing software or drivers. It plugs in. I have not found an OS that I had an issue on. The desktop syncing software, you have the option to back up all your data, as you can see here. And so you can back up your data, contacts, calendar, and syncing them with the PC. It also has media sync. There is tethering option available, although Virgin Mobile doesn't support it. There are applications that you can use to tether your data and use it off the phone, but just be careful, that violates Virgin Mobile. It's redundant. Virgin Mobile has PC cards that are unlimited. Freezing and lag. The 8530 has only froze once on me in 4 months. Buttons have always worked. The sensor here, responsive. Menus, it always just goes right to it, first touch. With the Samsung Intercept, it does freeze and lag, and depends on what applications and widgets that you're running. Yes, with a few tweaks, you can make the Intercept not freeze as much, though I still have not been able to figure out what to do to keep the drop-down notification bar from freezing. I can't really show that to you right now, but on occasion that will freeze up. And you can see the notification showing up here. When that happens, you just can't drag it down and get to the notifications that will be in this area. Next, let's go into adding ringtones. Selecting ringtones that are not the default ones. With the Blackberry, you go into the media folder. And here you can either take it from the music folder or the ringtone folder that's set there. And let's just go for this one. We'll go into the music. And so you go over the song that you want or the audio clip. Quickly press the BlackBerry key, and then you have the option there to set as ringtone. This one, you go into the music application, and you go up to the top, the songs tab, press and hold the song, and use as ringtone. Let's take a look at the text clarity. Here I have it on the same. I tried to get both of them about the same font size. As you can see with the BlackBerry 8530, although it has a smaller screen, with the text is crisper, it's blacker, whereas with the Intercept, Wi-Fi compatibility with the 8530, I have not had any issues with any Wi-Fi connection that I've had. Setting up is really easy. You can really configure and have a lot of options on hand entering on your Wi-Fi. With the Samsung Intercept, I did have issues with my particular router, which is a Belkin N Plus. And there has been other people, if you look on the Sprint forums, you'll see that they're having issues with the Wi-Fi on N routers and having to drop it down to just a BG on their router. Because if you have it on BG, and again, not all routers may do this, but BGN, after about 3 to 5 minutes, you'll completely lose your connection, and then you have to go in and turn your Wi-Fi off and then back on, and then refresh whatever you're doing. Updates for the phones. The 8530 has over-the-air updates, as well it offers updates with the desktop syncing software. Also with the desktop syncing software, you can download stuff straight off the internet onto your computer and install it into the phone with this software. You would go into applications and have it put it in the phone. With the Intercept is over-the-air updates only. No PC connectivity other than accessing the SD card. Currently it has Android 2.1. Personally, I'm not sure if they're even going to get Android 2.2. I really hope that they prove me wrong on that one. But if it does get the 2.2, you can install stuff off the SD card. Let's just hope that happens. It might fix a lot of little teeny issues in here.